Yeah, I'm doing it a bit early because it starts up quite quickly. And there we go, Parkasaurus. Yeah, I basically did everything of this game already. And to actually get to the game. No, I'm not loading. I'm going to the options and restart campaign. Yep, that's the whole point. And it also restarts the game. Okay. Well, yeah, Parkasaurus, a game I picked up about a week ago, a week or two. And I liked it very much. It's somewhat a combination of, I would say, Theme Hospital. The new reincarnation of that would be a Two Point Hospital. And, of course, Jurassic Park World. And yeah, I like this game so much that I already suggested some stuff that could be added or changed in the current game, or have also found some bugs. One of them I can tell you already is the exit to desktop. It doesn't work correctly. When I do this, it's basically telling me the program is not responding. And the only thing is going up here to the X button. This is how it actually works, but yeah. Also, if we keep on staying in here, I think the music just goes out after a while. And yeah, we literally have to unlock absolutely everything. And we also have to go through the tutorial. And of course, since we restarted the campaign, everything I've unlocked over here is now gone. Also, one thing, you can't unlock everything at once. You have to choose what you need. Because I think I didn't unlock the X, and also I suggested the point you shouldn't be able to see 3X 2 or 3. Yeah, I said it already, the music is already gone. Those shouldn't be seen yet. Only once we buy this one, then we can see. Ah, we can get another 3X. Okay, that's all the talking for now. We'll go to the tutorial. Learn important park building skills. I don't remember what we are going to learn over here, but yeah, it should be nice and quick, I think. Also, since this game is not. Yeah, I'll pick up some stuff around here. It seems we are rocketing ourselves into Earth then, from somewhere. And we crash landed, so to speak. And there they are. Commander Ollie here. It's nice to meet you, human. Would have been something if they actually talked to us in like. Since this is Steam, it would be like our Steam username then. Welcome to your first dinosaur park. Depends if you have already played Jurassic Park World. It wouldn't be the first one, but still. I will be looking into ways we can enhance the well-being of our dinosaur friends. Of course. This looks like a big empty area to set up our dinosaur park. There's quite a lot of garbage around, but every great dinosaur park has to start somewhere. Has to start somewhere. My brain is already autocorrecting stuff. The worst way. But first things first. Navigating around your park is easy and important. Let's give it a try. From Ollie. Yeah, all the three dinosaurs have different names, and we will see them. Depending on the level? I don't know, we will see. Of course, hold down the right mouse button and pan the camera. Just right-clicking is enough. Okay, use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Yeah. Wait a second, I just moved in, zoomed in and out once, and this was enough. And yeah, Q and E to rotate camera. I don't know if we could also... Nah, this is actually zooming? Maybe holding middle mouse button and scrolling up and down to rotate? Or holding middle mouse button and left to right to do this? But yeah. And the first round is done. And yeah, your first exhibit. Of course, since this is tutorial level, we have to build wherever they tell us to. Science Officer Luca reporting for duty. It's almost time to meet your first dinosaur. I'm excited to see how their biological systems function in this atmosphere. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Commander Ollie said we should set up an exhibit first. Exhibits are where your dinos live. You design exhibits to match your dinos' needs and increase dino happiness. For now, let's create a simple exhibit for your first dino. Select the wood fence to build an exhibit from Luca. And yeah, this is the hut, and I already have also some suggestions towards those, and we will get to that sooner or later, but first we need to build a fence. Basically, everything around here. And that's it. And now we need to put a door, and it's actually just anywhere. It doesn't matter where. But I mostly have a plan on where to do this. Maybe around here. And there we go. And the next one from the trio. PAX here. PAX East? Nah. I piled the crashed ship into your planet. Your money is very shiny. I mean, yeah, gold coins. That counts as money, so to speak. We should really be collecting as much of this stuff as possible. I invented a way to collect these coins in bins called donation boxes. And now I need to build one. Not yet all of those. Would have been suggestion worthy? I don't know. Also, to make it easy for them to donate quicker, just way near there. And your first best friend. For anyone who has none, let's get you a first Let's get you a first dinosaur. Could have been worded a little bit better, I think. This is very exciting for everyone involved. From Ollie. Stegosaurus? I mean, it's the same one as him, so I would say yeah. And all the stuff we are getting, this is the inventory. And yeah, stuff on that later. Once we get to it. There we go. And visiting town. Town is a great place to buy food. Of course, accessories for your dinos as well, but I'm not that much into that one because of something else. I get to it as well. Or get loans. It depends on that one. If you have excess amount of either money, hearts, or science points. And we will get to that later. I don't think it's worthy in the tutorial, but well, okay. We'll get to it. You can visit town anytime during the day, even at night time. But not at the very end of it. And yeah, we get to it then. And we need to buy some vegetables. Okay, just plants. And discounts. Now we have 6 of them. And yeah, escape to get out quicker. There are many different types of dino feeders. Of course, we will also get to that. Way later, I think. Upgrading and researching new dino feeders give various bonuses to your dinos. They'll be shown once we get to it. Your new dino is a vegetarian, so let's get a vegetarian feeder. And of course, and all of the stuff is in the exhibits. And this is the smallest and earliest one we get. And I will say somewhere around here. Caring for your dino best friends is a lot of work. Employees are a great help by doing many of the tasks in the park. Vegetarians are Veteranians? I might have mispronounced this one, but whatever. Are the primary caregivers for your dinos. Let's hire one then. And we have to go over here. For now, we have to view all of this. And since I said, is this almost like a theme hospital? Yeah, basically. Except for the security, and we will get to that. Yeah. What do they do? We fill food containers when have access to exhibits with doors. Only if they have doors. If there's a feeder inside but no doors, you'll get a message that said veterinarians can't get to it. And if there's a dino inside, that's not good. And I don't know if dinos are able to die. Maybe I think I might know what would happen, but I never let that happen. Only on accidents on some other cases. Well, we will see. Depends. Heal and take care of dinos. That's also for sure, and that's also important. And heal up clean up exhibits. Yeah, that's not the janitor's job. The janitor's job is to clean up the whole park. Not the exhibits. And what I'm going to do is get the cheapest one, which is in this case this one, permanent. And yeah, what I usually do is just usually pick up a level 1 one and check who is the cheapest. And yeah, hire them then. Work ethics. Okay, employees automatically find tasks to do in the park. That's all automatically then. Assign tasks. This is something we can assign to them as well. But I usually let them do everything. You can assign the tasks for your employees. And yeah, also something, you can always look up this information again in the Dinopedia located in the office. And since I am not that much going around in the office as well in the Dinopedia, it's basically easy to understand everything. So that's that. Also, yeah, it's actually, yeah, I should have paused to the very beginning. And yeah, wait a second, I paused? No, the game paused because of this then. No, it didn't pause. I was thinking about this one, but there is it. There he is. He or she, I haven't checked. The exhibit pane is a great tool to inspect the type of biome and biodiversity in your exhibit. This is very important. Every dino species has a particular biome they prefer to live in. You can create a biome in your exhibit by first placing a base tile and then morph the biome by modifying the wetness and terrain. And what we are going to do is just... You don't need to do that. Also, double clicking is enough, as it said that. And yeah, pause for a second, just in case. Here we have all the information about it. Also the area. This is very much important because of the dino itself. Because it requires at least 420 square feet. And since we have way than enough than that, we have enough. And yeah, appear is just everything in total, which is basically everything the dinos have, that is all here. And they can be raised, which is basically... I was too slow on that one. If you observe the egg before it hatches, and before you actually hatch it, depending, you can actually do some stuff with it. But I was a little bit too late on that one, so we might have to get to the first level to get to this. And yeah, this is also the place where you can give it hats and stuff. But as we can see, it's too young to wear a hat. And it takes... I don't know how long, several days for it to become an adult. And once it gets to that point, then it can wear hats. So yeah, also it's a male, so it's a he. So I was correct. Also terrain. What I mostly do is just do everything. And that's enough already. Also, while checking around here, it's not a rainforest, and it can be seen here as well. And what do we need? Mostly water. And what I'm going to do, usually, is everything on the side. This was almost enough. And what I am going to do to make it... Whoops! I didn't want to do it that much. Too much, god damn it. Every biome has an ideal ratio of trees and bushes to rocks. Wait, what? Did I say that correctly? Every biome has an ideal ratio of trees to bushes to rocks. Okay, I said it incorrectly. This ratio is called the exhibit biodiversity and contributes to your dinosaur's exhibit score. Trees, bushes and rocks can only live in particular biomes. Also something, we'll get to that later, once I fix this one again. Note that trees and bushes often need to be near water sources. That's why I am mostly surrounding the entire exhibit with it. And I usually do it one tile wide. Oh yeah, and because of that, even though it's enough to for the Mediterranean to go through the water, I just leave it at that so there's some space. And everything is done over here. And to look at everything, this is all we need. And I don't know the maximum we need around here. That would have been something if that got included. It could be... I might suggest that one. So, we get some pines. Also, some other things, because they have tears. And yeah, this is also something. We don't have sand ones unlocked, and I don't think we need those. Also, there are some better tears. And this is mostly because of something, because of this one. and I'll get to it again later. I usually do some eco stuff. Two more. That's also okay. And some rocks. Five is enough already. And next one, open for business. Oh yeah, we haven't even opened yet. And that's mostly the reason why I usually stop at the beginning. Usually, this is not the case in the tutorial, but in all the other missions. The park is already opened. So to have some dinos for the visitors to enjoy, I usually stop at the very beginning, prepare everything else, and then have them come in. So yeah, time to open the park so guests can visit. You can close your park at any point. Just remember, guests give donations and buy tickets. And that's where our money comes from. And yeah, everything looks okay, but it's with all of this, it only stays at 90%. How to get it to 100? Easy. Add the tier 2 ones. And as I showed them already, wrong one. It's this one and this one. And as it says, it's getting unlocked over here. But we won't go into it as of yet because we are not being told to. And it's open. Is that it already? No. A janitor is a key member for your park staff. A janitor can repair fences, which is needed because since all the dinos depends on their happiness, I mean, they usually attack the fence, and if they are happy enough, they do it less often. But if they're unhappy, they'll do it much more regularly. And yeah. Pick up garbage. Of course, if you don't have trash cans, empty toilets and more. A janitor automatically does tasks around the park, such as picking up garbage as well, of course. And for that we have to go into the office again. Same thing. And level 1 is enough already, and this is the only one. Also, I usually just let him do absolutely everything. While this is unselected by default, I don't know. Also, yeah, there's some trash around here. And let's have them pick it up. Actually quite slow. Oh, we have a twin. And yeah, we have our first visitors. And yeah, usually 80s T-posing. Nice. I didn't notice that one. might have been the same in Two Point Hospital. But, well, okay, yeah. Customers, this is very much important. This has been a lot of park training. Let's have guests arrive to the park to make some money. And we have some of them already. But since they already arrived, they don't count. And we have to wait for 5 more. And yeah, they are basically watching over him then. And there's the next one. And this is why the donation box is that good. Yay, and they're already happy with it. Okay, before the fifth one arrives, we will have a look at them. Yeah, mostly I don't usually look at that stuff or at the infos, mostly about the issues. Perhaps a few decorations would liven up this park, and not many options for food. Looking at their issues is very helpful to make the park receive more stars, and will depends if this one ends before the first day ends. I'll let the first day run out and then get to the next level, so I can show you the end of day screen. And there's the fifth one. And we got some more donations. And that's everything. And we got an imperfect gem. Nice one. Security training. Yeah, we also need security. Even though they are not that much needed if you know how to run a park. Nothing has ever gone wrong in a dinosaur park. Ahem. Especially movies about dino parks. Trust me. Just in case, how about me... Wait a second, what? Just in case, how about we give our security some practice in case one of your dinosaur best friends decide to adventure outside the exhibit? Let's say it like that. Learn to tranquilize a dino. And yeah, first we have to hire security. And the usual, this time we have mostly level ones, and I pick the cheapest. Click on the dino. Where is he? Also, yeah, I have suggested this one as well already. Currently, there's only an employee viewer where you can basically see all your employees. And yeah, the janitor is all the way back there. And yeah, there is no dino viewer, so I don't know where that little guy is. Since that little guy is so little, he can be hiding behind the grass or even behind the trees. I think I saw him. Hello there then. Okay, and for this, I have to close this one. We have to tranquilize. This is only when absolutely necessary. And the security guard is incoming. And don't worry, it's just a tranquilizer dart. And we got that one as well. I would like to have this one here. And yeah, everything we have tranquilized is in the dinosaur storage. And since this is just for practice, we get him back out there. Also, the park is closing in 10 seconds. Oh yeah, this is also something I might suggest. Because this is overlapping everything. Almost everything except this one here. Explore science. Yeah, we need that as well. For science points. Let's explore the world of science. Science credits are used in the science tree to unlock useful upgrades and items for your park. Yeah, mostly this is all stuff for your park, and this is mostly for the dinos. Like stuff like advanced feeders and stuff. And maybe some places for them to play with, to escape to, and whatever. The most common way to generate science credits is to have scientists work at the science building or at the science presentation. Could have been worded a little bit differently. But yeah, that is basically this thing. And we have it over here. Yeah, science is very good. Because it generates science credits. You generate science credits by placing a scientist on the science node. But first we have to pick them up. Pick up your scientist by selecting and using the icon. And then placing them onto the node. Science nodes are found on science buildings and presentations. First we have to hire one. And yeah, as I said, this should have been done better. Some more? Okay, he's a little, she is a little bit, it's a she, yeah. She's a little bit cheaper. And also, yeah, but I haven't even shown off what they do. Pick up trash, repair fences, and clean bathrooms. Just, okay. And here as well, tranquilize dinosaurs that have gotten loose. And I think there is one thing missing, and we'll get to that in another level, I think. I have you already. Wait a second. Scientists, this is what I want. Find dinosaur footprints by walking around the park. And when placed on the presentation booth, we'll provide science by teaching guests. It doesn't matter if it's if he actually has a crowd to present stuff. It's just to no one. It works as well. And can be used if the science lab generates science as well. And I hired someone already, I think. No, I didn't. Okay, now I did. And there it is. And there's the note. And set it to research. And yeah. Also, I am not skipping the first one, so I can show all of this off. Why does it say as computer? I mean, okay. I mean, it has some charts. End of the day is the good time to look at all aspects of your park. I wanted to say planet. We are not playing a dinosaur planet game, it's a dinosaur park game. And hearts. This is also something. And I have also something suggested over there. I mean, currently, hearts are rewarded at the end of the day for every dinosaur that is happy or very happy. And yeah, this is something I have suggested because I have one dinosaur, that's of course. But if this one dinosaur is super happy, then it shows me as happy and super happy. This was a little bit confusing for me once I had just one dinosaur and I saw 1 plus 1, even though I only had one dinosaur. What I suggested is basically I get one heart for every just happy dinosaur and I get two hearts for every super dino, super happy dino. And yeah, everything we gained for that day is everything that's in here. Also, what we earned, since we constructed a lot of stuff and I failed to stop the game, I didn't earn that much. Also, the appeal is not that much. Also, what is up with the ad test? I still don't know what that means. Maybe it was for testing stuff? Don't know. Also, this is basically the park. The reason why it's only having one star. Wait a second, since when do I have stuff on toilet, I think? I mean, food I have none. Fun is mostly of all the dinosaurs I have. And since I just started, it's not that much. So yeah. And also, it's the average of of everyone that is currently inside the park. And yeah, he will see all their reviews, which isn't that much helpful most of the time, even though was clean, was tidy, cool, saw a dinosaur, also read all my posts on DinoBook. Still just one star. And I could have done a little bit better to reflect the reviews, make them one star worthy and stuff. That is basically the reason why I said looking at the guests' issues is more important than what's being shown here. Also, yeah, all the science we have gained, but since we just started, we didn't gain anything. Also, yeah, this is just the overview. Financial stuff, it's just showing what we did and how much we spent and stuff. The dinos, also, this is also something I have suggested. To make everything listed like what we saw once we clicked on the dino. Because this is a little bit... there can be a little bit more information in here. And I've already had a few ideas on how to do that. Especially on here. And here as well, I think. So yeah, that is basically everything, and yeah, that's it for the day, and we'll continue on with the tutorial. And yeah, I would like to speed up the game then. And I don't know if I would suggest a triple speed up, because it depends. I mean, it's okay for now, but yeah, since we have to wait, maybe we get some more money from those. And since this is the only thing we need to do now, this is the only thing I'm going to do. And it really takes a while. Maybe I should have done it with a higher level one. Also, why they research, they gain experience. Also, yeah, even though we hired one with all ones, sometimes they have their stats raised a little bit. Also, the speed. Since it's doing very slowly, that would speed that one up. How efficient? I don't know. Is it that one? And personality depends. It's not that great for the lab. For the lab, it's only... Yeah, I can go back to it once we select that one, because it's explained there. Time to expand the park with more dinosaur best friends. Use the portal to dig up skulls and footprints to be used in the egg store. This is basically where you get all the dinos from. Also, yeah. Pick up a scientist to drop on the worker spot. Not a science note? Okay, goddammit, you are not... being... I mean, okay. Speed and ability are good skills for a scientist working here. Of course. Also, I have just one of everyone. And this is the only thing I am going to need, I think. Seems to be like that. I just let it that then. The time portal. Here we can... it's selecting the time period? Mostly what type of dino items we are going to search for. Still, it's a time portal to dig them up from, I would say, several years later after the meteor crashed. Select a time period. Okay, it might be a time period. I don't know. Below the portal to determine what dino parts to dig. And scientists dig. This is what we'll see shortly afterwards. And this is a little bit too small for me to read. I'm skipping that one. Also, yeah, fast forwarding. This takes a while. As well. Also, yeah, what's up with you? I really need to rest. This is also something that we might need. But since I'm not being told to, I'm not going to do that. Also, we can see it from here how much this has progressed. And we are going to see when it's ready. Since then, there are several ones in here. And of course, they all go away once they are too tired for everything. Also, quite a huge parking lot. I might do another suggestion in terms of that. Making it smaller and having that being upgradable. Because it looks way too large for that, and I don't think one would be able to fill up all of the spaces with visitors. So yeah. It's almost done. Okay, pausing for a second. We need to dig. And yeah, this is also running. Usually I am starting with this one and dig up all the edges and the middle one. After that, just playing Tetris. And I think that's enough. That's enough. That's enough. That's enough to unlock this one. That's enough to unlock this one, this one, this one, and everything should be unlockable almost immediately with this one. And that's it. Once it says zero items, you can return. There is no deal for you to continue onward. It would have been something if once we do something, they all gain a little bit of experience. Would have been something. But, it depends. And since we have some stuff, we can buy something. And, yeah. Those two we have unlocked already. But, yeah, for the Stegosaurus, we needed to dig up some other stuff. But we have this one first. And we can only have one of them. Remember the science credits? What are they good for? Let me tell you, science credits are used to unlock science technologies such as new buildings, upgrades, and perks. Go to the science tree and unlock a science technology. This is basically over here. I don't have it. Okay. And yeah, this is... Oh, you are up here. I might need to report that one as a bug, maybe? And yeah, there are many things to unlock. And yeah, what can we unlock first? Usually I pick this one, Science Learn 1, because of the Stone Science presentation. This is basically another means for us to gain more science stuff. Whoops. Well, we taught you everything I... wait, what? Not we. I have taught you everything I know about being a good dinosaur park manager. There's much more to explore, but you are on your own to gaining park fame and becoming a great park manager. We'll see. Nah, not that one. And yeah, we can do that then. Wait a second, I don't have enough. But one thing we could do is have this one. Have them bought daily, basically, and they're cheaper. Also, where is our security? There we go. He's not only good for tranquilizing dinos, but to also pick up deliveries. And since he keeps on going around wherever he shouldn't be. Okay, before the next day starts, also skip summary because I've explained everything already. Station. And have them run around this area. Did it count? It did count. Okay, go back then. There we go. Save complete. And why is this closed again? And yeah, we need a little bit to have this one done. And already having 20 guests. Almost enough for 500. Come on. And there we go. And this is the tutorial mission completed. We can basically continue on playing, but I would like to get a move on, so on to the true first level. And with that, I am cutting this part and start up the next part immediately after.